Hey everyone, Mitch from Abelcine here with Mark Shipman-Mueller, who is the product manager for all cameras and lenses at Aerie.
Hello, Mark.
Hi, how are you doing, Mitch?
All right, sir. It's a great show. We did a little early morning thing so we could have a little moment to talk. Well, not too crazy because the Aerie booth is always packed. Tell us about what is new with Alexa.
All right. Well, first we have the Alexa Plus camera, which is now shipping. And with the Plus camera, we also have the Remote Control Unit 4, the RCU4, that is also shipping, that allows you to remote control the camera from the left side or when the camera is up on a crane. The Alexa Plus, let me show you the other camera side here, allows you to plug lens motors directly into the camera, and then there's an antenna here that allows you to use our wireless remote system to remote control the camera. And we just inked and deal with C-Motion, so the C-Volution system from C-Motion can also remotely control the Alexa Plus.
So you have full integration between Aerie's wireless control system and C-Motion's wireless control system. They both interact directly with the camera?
Yes, that is correct.
Well, that's terrific. So what else is new? I got a big box up here.
Yes, this is a Codex onboard recorder, and this is a special onboard recorder Codex built just for Aerie. We're expanding our partnerships now with other companies in the industry. One of them, as I said, is C-Motion. The other one is Codex. This is a relatively low-cost Codex recorder that records only Aerie RAW. It'll run about $21,000. That's about 16,000 euros. And it only records Aerie RAW. If you choose to, you can upgrade it to the full-blown Codex. Then you pay the price that the full-blown Codex costs, and you can record all the formats the Codex can record.
So basically we're looking at a Codex that's specific for Alexa, and that way you don't have to pay for extra features. It's designed to really marry with your camera directly.
Yeah, that is correct. And we have a number of feature films that are shooting now with Alexa and Aerie RAW, and this, I think, is the way to go for the recording medium.
Terrific. What else do we have over here? Mark, I'm looking at an optical viewfinder on here. What is this camera?
Well, this is very exciting. This is the Alexa Studio, one of the three cameras we announced in 2009, I believe, as the Alexa camera system. This has an optical viewfinder here. It has a mirror shutter, and we have a 4x3 sensor.
So 4x3 sensor, that's added height for the same sensor technology. That's giving you what?
It gives you essentially plug and play if you shoot with anamorphic lenses. You can shoot with anamorphic lenses with a regular Alexa, but you get higher resolution if you shoot with a 4x3 sensor with the Alexa Studio.
Right, because if you have a 16x9 sensor on the other cameras, then when you shoot anamorphic, you're going to have such a wide frame that you're going to cut off the sides in order to get the frame you want. So with a 4x3 sensor, now you're going to use an anamorphic and get the kind of image that you want to get, a 2.4 kind of frame.
Yeah, that is correct. Now, the viewfinder is a completely new development that accepts the 435 and the Aerie-Cam eyepieces and eyepiece extensions.
Great, so it integrates into systems that everybody already knows and has.
That is correct, yes. And the camera also has all the features of the Alexa Plus. It essentially is an Alexa Plus backend with a brand new front end containing the mirror shutter, optical viewfinder, and the 4x3 sensor.
Available when?
Available December for 92,700 euros.
What a steal. So Mark, this is a total surprise. These are totally new kind of cameras that are based on the Alexa technology, but this was nothing ever in the sort of the long range plan that Aerie had ever shared with anyone.
That is correct. We did have it in the plan, but we decided to not start developing that. The Alexa is a complete platform where we have many, many other ideas that we still haven't shared. But this is the Alexa M here, which is essentially if you take an Alexa and you take the chainsaw and you chop her in two pieces, you get a front head and you get the back processing unit. And this is the front head. It is specifically designed for action photography, for when you try to shoot in tight corners, and obviously for 3D, because you want a small and lightweight camera here. This is around 5 pounds. And we have this here on a Cameron Pace lightweight 3D rig with a lightweight zoom. And as you can see, there's two cameras here. And this is a complete 3D rig that gets you the same amazing Alexa quality that you would have shooting with a camera that is put together.
And you don't have to use it in 3D. You can always use it as a separate head because this is small enough to squeeze into the smallest spaces, really.
Yes, that is correct. And we also have just inked a deal with the Cameron Pace group, that they will receive the first pre-production units, and use them on productions, do some testing for us, and then in the beginning of next year, these will be available to the public at large.
Terrific. Now, I know there's some, we're talking about all these fabulous new things that are coming, and but there's a lot that's still going on in development work, making new features available for your classic Alexa, if you will.
It's amazing to talk about something that came out last year as a classic piece of gear.
We move fast these days.
We do. So yes, this is true. We have software development all the time. There's new features coming with the new software, and one of them will be an anamorphic de-squeeze. This will allow you to de-squeeze the image in the viewfinder and on the monitor output.
And now, a 2.0 magnification on squeeze for anamorphic makes you a really wide frame, but there's another aspect of anamorphic that you have in there as well, right?
Right, which is the 1.3x de-squeeze. We can also de-squeeze in 1.3x lens.
Right, so there's some 1.3 anamorphics. It's only a relatively mild kind of stretching, and when you have the, or mild squeezing, I guess, and when you do that, you get from 16:9 to 2.4, so that's your CinemaScope frame.
Exactly, yes, and the Alexa will be able to do both 2x anamorphics and 1.3x anamorphics.
Terrific. What other features, type of features like that is coming along?
Well, aside from the Alexa M, one of the biggest responses we've gotten is the 120 frames a second. Somewhere in the fall, we hope earlier than later, we will have the ability to shoot 120 frames a second with any Alexa using the full sensor. There's no windowing.
So, full camera capability in using 120 frames a second. It's going to record to a form of ProRes, I believe?
Yes, it's going to record to a form of ProRes and to a memory card.
Thanks a lot.
Thank you, Mitch.